narration of the deceased to the god of the dead, Osiris. Now the lid is decorated with figures and text surmounted by the hieroglyphic symbol for sky.
Let's go.
Below which is placed a winged scarab.
Why aren't you kids in class?
This place is boring, man. We're out of here.
Boring?
Yeah, it's full of junk.
Junk? Junk? Well, some of the greatest adventures of my life are sitting in this museum.
Maybe it's cool for you, dude, but we think it stinks.
Hold on, or I'll clobber you.
Be cool, man. Be cool.
You from the city?
Me? I'm from just across the river.
Big deal.
Come on over here. Maybe you'll learn something. Now, what was it I was talking about?
Huh?
You heard me. What was I saying just now?
Something about...
Yes, yes. Now, I was born across the river in New Jersey. That's right. July the 1st, 1899. I guess that sounds a hell of a long time ago to you, huh? But let me tell you something. To me, it seems only the twinkling of an eye. I was raised in Princeton, where my father was professor of medieval studies. He was a very smart man. My mother adored him. She was the sweetest, smartest, most wonderful woman who ever lived. I can't say I was crazy about school either. I guess I thought I already knew everything. And I preferred having fun with my dog, Indiana. Playing baseball. Or maybe learning about other things. Like how to get to the moon. How to break the land speed record. Or how this mysterious thing called electricity works. Then one day something wonderful happened. My dad was invited to visit all these different schools and universities around the world. He wrote some important books, you see. So he was going to make this great trip, and we were going with him. The trip was going to take on close to 2 whole years. We boarded a giant steamship and sailed across the Atlantic Ocean. Our first stop was England, where we visited London, and then went on to Oxford, where my father had gone to university. He said he had a surprise for me. Some surprise. You think your teacher is tough? Let me tell you, she's a pussycat compared with Miss Helen Seymour, tutor supreme. Which seemed pretty much like the end of it, or so I thought. Only, like I said, my father was a very smart man. It took 9 days to sail across the Mediterranean Sea. I guess my mother and father had quite a good time on the voyage. I didn't get to see too much of it, though. Miss Seymour didn't let up on me for one bit of a minute. I'll say this for that woman. She was one tough old bird. We landed at Alexandria and then made our way up the Nile River to the ancient city of Cairo. I had never seen anything like it. Everything was so wonderful, strange, and exotic. As soon as we had settled in, my father started his lectures at Cairo University. Mother was busy helping him out on the social side with afternoon teas and things. So I was left to the tender mercies of the wicked witch. From time to time, I was able to explore things on my own. But for the most part, the goddess of knowledge kept my nose stuck in a book. He roared like the wind. The hand of God was upon him. "Don't forget me," he cried, "as if I ever would." The man was a hero even then.
Then what happened? Did he catch the killer?
When he got to the pier, the steamship had gone by 5 minutes and Demetrius with it.
So the bad guys got away?
Not exactly.
So what did you do?
Me? I went back to Cairo with Miss Seymour. We joined up with my parents and continued our trip.
Is that all?
Of course not.
So what about the jackal?
The jackal? What jackal?
The one with the eyes of fire. Did it ever turn up?
Yes. The jackal with the eyes of fire. Well, that's another story.
Oh, come on, mister. We gotta know what happened.
Oh, wouldn't you?
Hey, man, we gotta. Come on, mister, please.
Yeah. All right, but I've got to get home soon. Got to feed my cat, Henry. Very demanding creature, Henry. Makes my life hell sometimes. Okay, let's go. 8 years later, I was in Mexico.
What does Mexico have to do with it?
Listen, kid, who's telling this story, you or me?
You, sir.
Damn right, so shut up and listen. Now, where was I?
In Mexico.
I recall. It was spring break, and I was in Santa Fe visiting my cousin Frank. The weekend before I was to return to New Jersey, we decided to hitch down to the border to have a little fun. You know, with the senoritas. Little did I realize that the desperate financial needs of the revolutionaries in Mexico would lead me back to the jackal and change my life forever. I was only 16 years old. I think my cousin Frank was a little older. Yeah, now I recall, Frank was definitely a little older than me. I nearly missed meeting up with Remy, but I made it. And we slipped away. 2 weeks later, we took a boat out of Veracruz. I was on my way to enlist in the Great War. The war to save civilization. The war to end all wars.
Mr. Jones?
Mm-hmm.
What happened to the jackal?
The jackal?
The Young Indiana Jones Chronicles will be right back.